Hello students, in this lesson we will discuss the P block elements, and here in this video we will see the preparation and properties of nitric acid. So here in this video we will see the chemical properties of nitric acid. First of all, we will see the acidic character. In aqueous solution, HNO3, that is nitric acid, behave as strong acid, giving hydronium ion and nitrate ion. It turns blue litmus to red. Here's the reaction. HNO3 when reacts with H2O, then the reaction will yield H3O positive ion, that is hydronium ion, and NO3 negative ion, that is nitrate ion. Here's the another reaction. You can see NaOH, that is a base, when react with HNO3, that is nitric acid, then the reaction will yield NaNO3, that is sodium nitrate and water. While CaO, that is calcium oxide, that is also a base, when react with HNO3 nitric acid, then the reaction will yield CaNO3 twice, that is calcium nitrate. So you can see that when HNO3 reacts with base, then it will provide nitrate compounds and water. And in these reactions, HNO3 is showing its acidic character. Now we will see the decomposition reaction. HNO3 decomposes on heating. Here's the reaction. HNO3 when heated, then it will decompose to nitrate, NO3, oxygen and water. Here we will see the action of nitric acid on metals. With the exception of gold and platinum, HNO3, that is nitric acid, attacks all metals, forming a variety of products. The product depends upon the nature of metal, the concentration of acid, and temperature and nature of the material undergoing oxidation. In the case of metals that are more electropositive, like magnesium, aluminium, manganese, zinc, iron, lead, etc., nascent hydrogen is liberated, which further reduces HNO3. Here's the reaction. M, that is the metal, when react with HNO3 nitric acid, then the reaction will yield MnO3 whole twice, that is metal nitrate, or we can say the nitrate compound of that metal. And we also get here nascent hydrogen, and this nascent hydrogen will again react with HNO3 and will yield reduction product and water. Now we will see the reaction of nitric acid with zinc. Here are the reactions. You can see when zinc will react with concentrate HNO3, then the reaction will yield zinc nitrate ZnNO3 whole twice plus nitric oxide NO and water. While when zinc will react with dilute HNO3, then the reaction will yield zinc nitrate as in the above case, but as a byproduct you will get N2O and water. While when zinc react with very dilute HNO3, then it will form ZnNO3 whole twice, that is zinc nitrate, plus NH4NO3, that is ammonium nitrate. So these are the reactions of nitric acid with zinc. Now come to the oxidizing nature of nitric acid. So HNO3 behave as strong oxidizing agent. It has tendency to give oxygen as nascent oxygen. Here's the reaction. You can see HNO3 is decomposing in nitrogen dioxide and will give nascent oxygen and water. Concentrate HNO3 oxidize non-metals and their compounds. Iodine is oxidized to iodic acid. You can see the reaction for this. I3, that is iodine, when react with HNO3, that is nitric acid, then the reaction will yield HIO3, that is iodic acid, and as a byproduct you will get NO2 and H2. While when HNO3 will react with carbon, then carbon will oxidize to CO2 gas. Here is the reaction. You can see carbon when react with HNO3, then the reaction will yield CO2 gas and water and NO2 also. So these are the chemical properties of nitric acid. Now we will see the brown ring test for nitrate ions. The familiar brown ring test for nitrates depends on the ability of ferric ion to reduce nitrates to nitric oxide, which reacts with ferric ion to form a brown colored complex. This test is usually carried out by adding dilute ferrous sulfate solution to an aqueous solution containing nitrate ion and then carefully adding concentrated H2SO4 along the sides of the test tube. A brown ring at the interface between the solution and H2SO4 layers indicate the presence of nitrate ion in solution. Here's the reaction for this. NO3 negative, that is the nitrate ion, when react with Fe2 positive ion and protons, then the reaction will yield NO, that is nitric oxide, and Fe3 positive ion and H2O. Here in this reaction, you can see Fe2 positive ions has the ability to reduce nitrate to nitric oxide, which further reacts with Fe2 positive ions to form a brown colored complex. So this is the brown colored complex formed by the reaction of nitric oxide with Fe2 positive ions. And here you can see this is the source of Fe2 positive ions. So this is the brown ring test for nitrate ions.